Everyone to the Real Whovians Cast, episode 745. That's getting harder and harder to say. I am your host, Matrix Lord 212, and I'm with Chris. What's up, Chris?
Everyone can rejoice. The Sonic Screwdriver shall return.
Yes. What's up, Ray?
I'm great. I'm glad the Sonic Screwdriver is back.
What's up, Sally?
What's up?
What's up, Scott? There you go. All right, program guy. Nice. Okay, so Chris told me today it has been confirmed as confirmed can be. The Sonic Screwdriver is officially back. I don't know if it's going to be before Christmas, but there it is right here, right? That's Peter Capaldi right there. You see my cursor?
Yeah.
Nice and blue and gold. And it looks like a TARDIS thing, if, in a way, if you look at it, where a thing goes up and down. It kind of looks like that a little. Now, this other device that she has, what is that, like a sonic crossbow? What the hell is that?
The name of it is in that article somewhere.
Okay. So let's see. It's Christmas Day on a remote human colony, and the doctor is hiding from Christmas carols and comedy antlers. But when a crashed spaceship calls upon the doctor for help, he finds himself recruited into Riversong's squad and hurled into a fast and frantic chase across the galaxy. King Hydroflax, Greg Davis, is furious, and his giant robot bodyguard is out of control and coming for them all. Will Nardole, Matt Lucas, survive? And when will Riversong work out who the doctor is? All will be revealed on a starliner full of galactic supervillains, and a destination that Doctor has been avoiding for a very long time. What else does it say? It's called The Husbands of River Song. Husbands of River Song. Don't know, and she's wearing a different outfit. Look at that outfit. She's got a ring on, and she's got this weird blue outfit on. Now, do we have anything else that says that what the name of it is? Not on this thing, right?
I saw the name of it somewhere. It might be in the comments there. Someone said the name of it.
Okay.
And do you think that squad could be the same squad that she was in the Silence of the Library?
Yeah, I wondered about that too. I don't know.
Because it says squad, doesn't it?
It looks like there's just a wooden model of Sonic. I don't know. There's something about two Sonics. We're gonna have to go to another site and check that out. Now, you think the Husbands of River Song is meaning the doctors, right?
That's the way I took it. Are we going to see his regenerations? Because technically, aren't they supposed to be married?
Yes, Sally. Well, I mean, here's the thing. I don't. Okay, I was talking to you off air, right?
Right.
And we're like. It's sort of like the I thought it was funny what I said. It was like the doctor marrying River, but in his car with the car closed and her on the outside. Okay?
That sounds disastrous.
Now, I don't know why you would get married to somebody inside your car with the doors closed and her outside, but technically it was because the test selector was like his car. So... You know, it's she kissed the car door, basically. I mean, all right. Is he married? Is he not? It's not like they got married via Skype or anything. I mean...
Hey, I got married that way once.
Yeah, well, I mean, see, that's the thing. I mean, I don't, you know, so... Or virtual reality. I mean, they're married even though he's, like, miniaturized and, like, in a car,
I guess. Looks like the thing you put on top of a wedding cake.
Right.
It's waiting to happen.
It's hard to tell if she kissed the bumper when she kissed the test selector or what part that was, but he's in there somewhere. Okay, so, like, stretching it, it's kind of like, yeah, they are married, as far as I'm concerned.
It's like he said, I do, and then he just drove off.
Yeah.
Well,
I mean, he says he's married.
Basically, yeah. He, you know.
But
yeah,
that's the way I've taken it. I mean,
I'm just waiting to see if this is the doctor.
You're waiting to see what?
I'm just waiting to see if this is a doctor or if it's number 13.
I don't even know who the hell doctor she is right now. I mean, like, they confuse the crap out of me. I think Moffat doesn't even know, to tell you the truth. Honestly. What do you think, Scott? Oh, Schmoogle is acting up.
You think they did?
You cursed us, Chris. You cursed us.
Chris jinxed us for Christmas.
Now, just because I said get married in a car doesn't mean anybody should get married in a car. You know, get next to your bride. That's ridiculous. Only happens in Doctor Who, but, you know.
You might start a trend on Twitter.
Yeah,
hashtag car wedding.
Okay. Also, to throw a little thing at you, what doctor did the Doctor and Martha go to the wedding to? Because in Blink, the Doctor tells Sally Sparrow that he went to see his own wedding, and that, like, they say these things so fast that you gotta catch it, you know, because it could mean something later on, you know? So, did he go back in time to see his first self get married, or did he go forward in time? I think it was forward in time. Like, did he watch, like, you know, what was that? That's something to think about. Maybe he witnessed, you know, Peter Capaldi getting married, because technically, when he looked at him, you know, and from his perspective, he could have met him already as a doctor, and that's why he took to Caecilius. Because if he was with Martha Jones, this is after Martha Jones fires at Pompeii, he's with Donna Noble. So, timey-wimey stuff, but yeah, basically. I'm thinking they're going to get married, like, officially, River and the Doctor, I think, Peter Capaldi.
Oh, that could be, too. I don't know.
What do you say, Ray?
It's hard to tell, really, because, like you said, Moffat doesn't even know what's going on, so how the hell are we supposed to know?
Right. Scott, if you want to talk, you could probably drop out, come back in. Because I think it works, right, Chris, if we do that?
I don't want to say anything.
In theory.
It worked with me yesterday.
In theory.
Right. Touch wood.
Right. So, I think it was Jessica Jones also made fun of that too, about Doctor Who. You can't have an explosion and an implosion. I think it was. I'm pretty sure I saw that.
Hang on, here we go.
They made so many references in Jessica Jones about Doctor Who.
Right. Scott, can you hear us?
I can hear you just fine.
Oh! Yay!
Hey!
So, like I was saying, I was always. There we go. Program guide from the earlier series.
Nice. All right. So let's look at these pictures again. Scott, I want your input on this, man. Let me just.
Because I know in Face the Raven they showed a close up of a sign that said DeLorean. And that was in, I forget the language off the top of my head.
Right. Give me one second. Actually, hold on. La, 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 la. All right, here we go.
I was just thinking, you know, that regeneration.
Yeah.
And we were still thinking that Paul McGann and David Tennant could be in a finale.
Yeah, which I doubt they're in now for some reason.
I know. But I was just thinking, during the day, what happens if the general time regenerated into one of them?
I was possible.
To get back to the Doctor.
Or regenerate into one of his forms?
That would be messed up, man.
That probably would piss him off, to tell you the truth.
That's what I mean. That could be what throws him over the edge and turns him into the Vale Yard. If one of them.
It kind of looks like his jacket is a cross between a dark purple, like somewhat of a Trenzalore-ish, you know, 11th Doctor thing.
Yeah.
It is purple, actually.
It's the same one from the finale, isn't it?
I don't think so. That's purple.
Look at that background. That looks like that forest that they landed in on Trenzalore.
Uh-oh.
So this could be the Sleeping Towers episode.
Okay. We also got word, if you saw the video earlier today, they had a joke video where...
Yeah, Peter Jackson.
Yeah,
I saw that too.
Everybody, I'm going to put the link below to that.
Oh, I saw it. I love
pretty
it.
Pretty funny.
You know, since Doctor Who's on, that means Walking Dead.
I, you know, that's what everybody really watches too, Walking Dead also. Even the Rubians, everybody loves that. Like, you know, Matt Smith and all that. All the Doctor Who fans watch Walking Dead probably too, because that's a great show also. So, and he was making fun of Moffat. That was the greatest thing. He's like, this guy's writing at like 2 in the morning. This nut, he don't even know what he's saying to me. We joke about that all the time. We joke about that all the time. We called it right. Like, this is what he probably does. He's like watching TV all day. He's like, oh, I'm going to 2 in the morning, 3 in the morning. And then, like, Peter Jackson make fun of him. Like, you know, that's not a good enough email for me to read. Like, he's writing it half asleep and he's judging the email like a script. I'm not going to read that. That was great.
I wonder what his response will be to it.
And that's at Peter Capaldi. But see, that was the joke because he would not do the episode unless they gave him a Dalek.
Yeah.
So that's his Dalek.
Yeah.
They're giving him that Dalek. So that's it. He got, and he signed the contract. That's it. He is doing it now officially. Series 10. Fantastic. Don't know when, but he's not going to be in New Zealand. He's going to be in 14 days in Cardiff. So. Yeah.
That's what they said.
That's what they said, yeah. They don't have that much money.
I'm just concerned about how this class one is going to turn out.
Oh, yeah. Class.
To be honest, I'm pretty worried about it at the moment. If it's only going to be on like a sub-channel for the BBC.
See, the thing is, when I heard about it, you know, I was kind of harsh when I first announced it. And then I felt bad because I'm like, all right, you know what? Give the guy a break. Why am I coming down on this guy? I felt so bad I went and bought his book, you know, and I put it on I bought an ebook of the Fifth Doctor, you know, when he had the Fifth Doctor, and I read half of it. But, you know, he's a good writer, man. I mean, from what I read, a little bit of it, I liked it. And, you know, if this is his way to get into Doctor Who is to get like a trial run with class and then maybe even take over Doctor Who or work on Doctor Who.
Please.
I mean, so I do have to apologize for becoming very harsh on class. I mean, that wasn't really fair, but, you know, we at the time, we all want to see Doctor Who, and if something interferes with Doctor Who, like when Sherlock was being made instead of Doctor Who, we get pissed off, you know? I mean, I get pissed off more than anybody. Because I get crazy with stuff. I'm like, you know, this is not right. They're going to film this. What's happening? What? What do you mean there's 8 episodes of Class? What is Moffat doing? He's not doing the floors with a mop. What is he doing? Is he the showrunner of Class? I don't know. And then they say he's not the showrunner of Class. And I'm like, what is he doing? Is he getting the coffee for that guy? No. He's writing the episodes too. And I'm like, oh my God, Moffat's busy. Moffat's busy. Moffat's busy. So I get into a panic.
What do you do? All right, this is what they should do. Okay, set it up to where, okay, Doctor Who's on hiatus. We write for Class, or we write for Sherlock. When one of those two are on hiatus, he writes for those other two.
Right.
Don't try to burn your candles at both ends, otherwise...
Right. Okay, before we go any further for a second, I do want to... So I don't know if you guys can see. Okay, we're going. There it is. This is a river-centric episode. So, Gloria. Hello, Gloria.
Hello, Gloria.
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 Okay.
Oh, no. It's
no, it's
okay. It's a Schmoogle thing. So, Gloria,
it's beautiful.
Gloria, you gotta drop out and come back in. It's the new Google.
It really is my fault.
You did.
We don't like the new Google because this is what happens. But Gloria, we can't hear you. I just see green balloons. I don't know. But yeah, I know that's Glenn. But anyway, yeah, drop out, come back in, and then maybe we can hear you.
But can't she hear us? Oh, I guess she can't.
Obviously, she did. Yeah. Gloria. Okay. All right. So. All right, so that you know, I knew she would.
Hang on.
All right.
Let's just see.
Can you hear me?
Hello.
Hello. All right, Gloria. This is Sally. Meet Sally.
Hi.
Right.
Hello.
There you go. I know.
That was a good idea, Sally.
All right, green balloons. So, green balloons.
Hey, it's good.
What are you
talking about? Green's
your balloons.
Listen, Greeny.
Greeny.
All right, Greeny. So, what do you think of...
Beautiful. I saw it already. It's beautiful. I'm telling you, that is one of the most beautiful things I've ever seen.
So that's your new profile pic, I guess, now that...
I love that you can do a 3D.
Oh, yeah, I've been thinking about changing it to that, but
Now that the other thing is over, Greeny, I think you can.
Mm-hmm. My profile pic's worse, I think.
But you know what you could do, Greeny? You could zoom into that super suit. No, not even him. The hell with him. You can zoom into her.
Yeah,
she's like
cool.
Action hero with this.
Yes, she is.
She's got this weird belt thing that could hurt, and I think she's got like tasers. Look at that thing. It looks like a powered suit that can mess people up.
But yeah.
And that's his pillow and his inflatable mattress because he got in trouble, so he's running away. Yep. The doctor, yeah. So is that a knapsack?
When do we expect you to Photoshop your face onto Rivers?
You know what I love about that? I love the bottom part. It looks like there's a skirt over the pants. It's like pretty cool. It's like she's awesome.
Such a weird thing, right? Her hair,
she's
too.
She's the only person that could wear a pant with a skirt over it and it looks stylish.
Yeah.
I like his purple jacket, though. It's
trans. Yeah, beautiful.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's the significance of the red button that's just like that? Is there a significance to that? He has one red button. And then the other one's
a red button. I'm wondering about that too. When I first saw it, I was like, I noticed that. I was like, why is there like a red button instead of
maybe sort of in memory of Clara.
Maybe, yeah, maybe.
Maybe. I mean, there it is.
Yeah.
Now, if you look at this, device, it sort of looks like something out of Star Trek. There.
Damn.
Yeah.
It looks like an Enterprise or something, or whatever that is.
Sonic Enterprise.
Before it could Sonic, yeah.
It could be a Sonic Blaster or something. You know, she did have one before, if you remember.
Wonder if that top part is detachable.
I don't know.
Maybe.
Yeah.
It might be just for like...
Click that off and use it as a separate item.
Yeah.
I don't know.
That would be cool.
Like a whistle.
That kind of sort of reminds me about, you know, those old timey guns that have like swords at the end.
Yeah.
That's what it reminds me of a little.
Now what did you think of the title, Gloria?
Oh, it's beautiful. I like it.
The husbands are in a song?
Yeah, it's okay. I mean,
as long as the husbands are the doctors, right?
Yeah, I guess that was the first thing that popped in my head.
See, that was the last thing that popped in my head. I was all upset, and like Sally's like, no, I think this is it. I'm like, all right, because I was pissed. I was like, hot.
That's weird how the girls, we know what it means, but the guys don't. Why is that?
I don't know. I was pretty hot. I'm like, this is not right. That's messed up. And it made like, and she's like, no, it's the doctors. I'm like,
including maybe there's another face of the doctor that shows up in it, maybe. It's like, I don't know. But what I thought when I heard it. I was like, automatically I thought, well, of course, because all his faces is the same character.
Now, does this episode lead into the audio where maybe she has another husband? I mean, is that...
I don't know.
Boys.
Who knows?
Or it could lead into the there could be a one where, like in the new series, where she's got two doctors with her, like she said, where she spends her birthday.
Two faces for a birthday, two doctors for a birthday.
Now, Chris, if this red robot replaced the friggin' droids from Phantom Menace, that would have been so much better.
Seriously, maybe this episode we see that, Joe.
They know how to build a better robot, I think.
Doctors for the birthday.
Yeah. Oh, maybe two doctors, so maybe they throw some David Tennant in there, maybe. Yeah. She met him already. I'm telling you right now, she met David Tennant already. He'll probably lock lips or something with her. I'm telling you. Probably grab her and stuff.
Well, so you think that they met after silence in the library?
Abso-friggin-lutely.
That she's met him another time.
I'm telling you right now, I'm so sure of that. So sure.
like later on in his timeline, because he met her the first time in the library.
She knew him already. That. She's like, "Yeah, I know who you are, man.
You're too young. I know."
We had such a good time. I didn't even look in your eyes. All right,
it was dark. There's like a strong possibility, a rumor saying that Stephen Moffat said that the one who takes her to the what do you
Friends
call it? Picnic at Asgard was actually right. David Tennant.
I thought Picnic at Asgard was Lake Silencio when they were having a picnic and they were drinking
that's
water.
That's what I thought too, yeah. But I don't think so.
Maybe not.
Because you would think Asgard, you think of course, a lot of us think of course the...
Right away we saw Odin, we're like, oh, here we go.
Yeah.
We got to have some David Tennant.
Fake Odin.
I would love to see some more interaction with him and her and Tin again.
He's so awesome in Jessica Jones. God.
Yes, he is.
He said, blink or you're dead. I can't believe that. That was great. He said, literally, you blink, you're dead. And like, oh, that was so awesome.
They probably allowed him to input that line.
He said, get in the Sonic car. I'm like, oh, my God. He must be. Wow.
They're having a field day with him.
They are such fans. He was doing well. He did his classic a couple of times.
Yeah.
Okay.
They're having a field day with that.
I know.
We don't blame them.
I finished Jessica Jones. I watched it on Sunday. Oh, fantastic. I can't say right now because we're in a real movie spot. It was kind of related. But we'll talk about that on the Everything Show. But, I will be up for David Tennant return.
I didn't get to say this yet because I didn't do any of the shows after it. But goodbye, Clara. We'll miss you. Love you.
Yeah, the damn Raven. I wanted to take that bird and put him in the microwave like you did with the Gremlins.
I don't know about you, but it just didn't befit her of a death, if you know what I mean. It wasn't her kind of way to die. She seemed a bit more braver than a raven just going in and messing her up.
When she did that moment, which is like, let me be brave. If I was Peter Capaldi, I'd be like running in front of her, grab that raven by the throat, and like snap its neck. And he'd be like,
I would have gone and grabbed her shield and said, no, you're taking this now. You put me in this.
Yeah, she heard them.
Probably. Well, technically, if he would have killed, not that he would kill a shoulder, but if he killed the shoulder, then that thing would be done because it was connected with her.
Yeah. That's what I mean.
Yeah, or he would have knocked her unconscious. He should have just knocked her out or something with a ray or something. I don't know, whatever. But anyway.
I agree with Ray. I would have shoved her happy little focus in front of that bird.
Yeah, that's not the way it works. I don't want to see her go out that way. I don't like any of that. And if their memories were erased, why does Riggsy remember her dying and painting the TARDIS? That made no sense either, because she says that all their memories are going to get erased, but that doesn't make any sense anyway. You know, but still, it was a shocking episode. It was fantastic. Yeah. And, you know, Hellbent. I mean, I'm sorry. Yeah, Heaven Sent. Heaven Sent was
an interesting twist, I have to say, where they opened it and then they made it when they revealed that all those he's sort of like in a time loop, like he said. And
yeah, he really worked his ass off, Moffat, on that. I gotta say, I mean, like, I have to give that a high rating. I mean, that's I think I gave it a rating already, but I think I'm gonna raise it to 9 because I think that was just, I keep watching that every day. If I'm watching it every day, that means I like it like Rings of Akkadan. So yeah. I mean, you know, so that's pretty cool. So that's gonna get a 9 for me so far. But
the fact that he kept hitting that diamond wall, and each time he hit it, he would get closer and closer to explaining the eternity.
That was great. Now, we also have something else tonight. We have some massive spoilers about Hellbent that I want to read. Really important stuff. So, and it's going to, and again, spoilers, guys.
I don't want to know.
You should have
come on,
Gloria, don't be a kissing.
Come on, Greenie. All right.
If you can see with her, then you can see these.
By the way, that you never met Ray, but there's Ray. Okay.
Oh, hello.
Yeah. Hello. I'm the newest one.
Well, welcome.
Well, I'm the new regeneration of the Uvians.
Yeah.
Okay, so now we have a... Let me go to... I think it's on Blogter. Was it on Blogter, Chris? I think I saw some on Blogter. Ooh. Let me see.
Chris is not saying anything because he doesn't want to jinx anything now.
It's totally on Blogter Who.
Alright, here
we go. That's it.
Alright, here we go. Are you ready? Are we ready?
Yep.
Fire one ready, Grizzly.
There's a massive one in there, so look for it. Alright, here we go. Here are 15.
Wow.
15! 15 scores. No, here we go. Ready? 15. Here we go. Why are they ringing all the bells? Never heard so many. All right. Sink that in. All right, here we go. Will all non-military personnel please step away from the doctor? Wait. I got to say this with a straight face. All right.
Okay.
Wait. All right. Stop. You're making me laugh. Stop.
I don't even know what's so funny.
Stop. Just stop. All right. Come on. I know it's funny. Come on. All right. Ready?
I'm laughing because I don't even know what's laughing.
Okay. Will all non-military personnel please step away from the doctor? At least move the children away.
Okay, yeah. You guys, no problem.
Yeah, at least move the children away, because the other ones can regenerate. All right, I think he's finished his soup. Let's see. Words are his weapons. When did they stop being ours? The doctor does not blame Gallifrey for the horrors of the Time War. He just blames you.
Ooh.
Hmm. Oh, James is here.
Hi, James.
What's up, James?
Howdy!
Wait, James.
Oh, for fucks.
Wait, James. James?
Still have a problem.
Hello, James.
Oh,
Houston, we have a problem.
Damn,
it's still working.
Good night. Houston, we have a problem. The connection's dropping.
Something's wrong.
I don't like the new Google. The only thing I like about the new Google is the way that you could actually press a button on the instead of having
we're
a whole
testing
button,
it out and it doesn't work. Okay.
Even though,
we're using the beta.
Hey Joe, the only thing I like about it is that when you're scrolling, there's actually a button for the scroller instead of having to hold the scroller down and pushing it and up and down and up and down because it's harder. But there's actually a button for it. Now, I like that, but other than that, I hate it.
My mouse is set up with the whole face is the...
Scrolling.
Google lies.
Okay, so now, James, you're going to have to drop out to come back in so we can hear you, because this is the way the new Google is.
It's pain in
the
butt.
James, and it worked, so...
All right, so let me read the teasers again.
Again.
The search engine lies!
Google lies and leaves us in damned land.
Alright, you like a cliffhanger, don't you?
No.
Okay, there was a saying in the Time War, the first thing you notice about the Doctor of War is he's unarmed. Okay. How many regenerations did we grant you? Oh, that's the main one.
Ooh.
Right there!
Oh, somebody was.
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Yay!
I wonder how many.
Okay, so some Time Lord was being a douche. obviously, he said that to the doctor. How many regenerations did we grant you? Well, how would you? Wouldn't you know? Because he don't know.
If that's the president, then that's stupid.
Yeah, it's probably not the president. It's probably the general idiot. Okay. So,
yeah.
Prophecies, they never tell you anything useful, do they?
Nope.
There's a sound...
No.
Yeah. There's a sound we've been living with every day of our life that you've learned not to hear.
Is that the four drums, like Marcel?
Well, that was a massive,
yeah. Yeah, but that sounds like something that sounds connected, doesn't it? There's a sound that he... Because he never heard it, did he? The doctor.
You died billions of years ago. Ooh. Meaning the Doctor, yeah. I guess. Your death is an established historical event and cannot be altered.
Oh.
Claw, probably.
Oh, could that be hinting that they are going to go back to Trelawney in the...
Well, no, I think that's Clara. He's talking about Clara.
Oh, I think so. Right.
Thought she would have been dead, what, 2 billion years?
I'll try not to break your jaw. Yeah. Oh, I guess the doctor says, I'll try not to break your jaw. And then he punches him in the face.
McClintock, I won't hit you. I won't hit you.
The Time Lord lies.
Yeah. Why would a computer need to protect itself from the people who made it?
Oh, like HAL 9000?
Why is it you spend so much time on Earth? Ah, that is...
I was thinking about that earlier. What happens if he gets exiled from Earth again?
Nah, I don't think so. But he'll probably be like, Daddy, my daddy's a half. He's a human and my mom's a Time Lord.
No, my mother married Davros.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Okay. I hope not.
Well, is he the hybrid or Shield is the hybrid?
I think the doctor.
I'm saying they're going to say the doctor. They're going to use the doctor to lie thing because he said he was the hybrid at the end of the.
No, but did he mean that hybrid is me? Like Joe saying, like it's a Shield.
In the movie, he said he was part human.
Okay. Right, but the Shield's name is me because that's a stupid name. But me.
You and a dog named Boo.
Yeah, my name is me. Your name's you. So let's just stop that.
So here's the thing: does Moffat like to erase everything that Neil Gaiman writes about, or is it me?
Yes,
I think so.
Like, does he really have to erase everything he writes about? Because as far as I know, Nightmare and Silver, he says, "Oh, this is Mr. Clever, by the way." That means either Cybermen can add. And they're terrible at information. But he's like, you're 100% alien. Meaning, like, you're not human at all. So, what the hell is...
I think he's
like, you know, like half and half. Like 1%. Like a coffee thing. He's probably like 1% human or something. I don't know what it is. No, seriously.
I'm sure he's already girlfriend, but it's just he's lying in the movie. Exaggerating.
Or when he went back to Skybro and Davros tricked him and getting up some of his regeneration energy, did he get any feedback loop from that or anything?
I don't know. He said the Dalek is not part of the equation hybrid thing. That's just Davros talking smack.
Yeah, but you know
the Dalek
eyes, so you never know.
Yeah, but it's like, I'm not being rude, it's like in a girl who... died. He was looking at a shield that, like, he already knew her, and then all of a sudden she's the one who kills off Clara, basically.
Yeah. I mean, so he'll pop back in time. He's like, oh, what ship?
I know who you are, Shielder. You're the one who kills my best friend.
he'd probably go and get the chip and break it, and then he'll see himself like, hey, what's up, man? That's all right. You just see me. Take care, right? That's it.
Or he'll take his sonic shades and from the other doctor and take.
Could somebody just take the sonic shades
and break them? Break them, destroy them, black hole, do something with them.
I'd love that to happen in this episode coming up. The Time Lord's just like, they don't need this anymore.
I hope River grabs the shades in the Christmas special, throws it in the air, and blasts it.
This ain't Star Wars.
The Doctor will go back in time and he'll like be like, "Hey, remember what you realized about your face? You're wrong."
No, not my face.
Well, it looks like we're not even seeing the part where he goes into the 50th. Like he may decide, "Oh, you know what? Screw this. I'm gonna undo everything I did and let them die."
Oh, man.
Yeah.
And he will be the last Time Lord, him and the Master.
Well, I'm not being rude. I'm looking at him in the trailer. He looks like in that kind of mood where he doesn't give a damn about the Time Lords anymore.
All right, I got one of my Matrix Lord crazy theories. Are you ready for this?
Dun, dun, dun.
What if Clara asked the Time Lords to give, you know, to help the Doctor, and Clara listened? meaning the Clara that was a Time Lord. It's like, oh, okay, sure, Clara. All right, Clara. And she just gives him... She just turns on the faucet. She gives him, like, 1,000 regenerations. Nobody knows what happens. And they're like, oh, we just are missing 11,000 regenerations or something.
And, like, oh, and then give Missy none and just like, yeah, I ate you.
Well, maybe that Clara turns her into a woman.
So would this mean the cafe that she was in would be a TARDIS as well?
See, we talked about that at the other show, but I honestly think it's not. I think that they went there because it's a still point.
Yeah.
A still point becomes a fixed point. So I think that they went there because that's like a, like sort of like the Medusa Cascade. It's kind of weird. You know, some weird thing could happen with the Medusa Cascade that Tom could be whatever. So they probably went, he went there because if any miracles happen, it's going to happen in that freaking diner.
Well, yeah, I was also thinking, you know, in old Classic Who, and the Master's TARDIS was all black. Do you think that's what's happening with Missy's TARDIS, that it's still all black, or it's red or something?
Well, the Doctor thought that she had a TARDIS in Death in Heaven, because he said it, that, oh, she had to have a TARDIS to go back and forth through time all those times.
But it's Vortex Manipulator, isn't
it? Yeah, but not that many amount of times. She went ridiculous amounts of times. I mean, like, beyond ridiculous.
His entire lifetime, look like.
Yeah.
Yeah, she can't keep, like, zapping herself 100,000 times and blasted every time. So,
well, anything can happen with Moffat.
Even the river does it.
We forgot one thing, though.
Moffat's writing it, so.
Yeah, since Clara died, so won't be no Orson Pink.
Well, then there's no Doctor.
I guess that...
Hang on. Unless some...
Then it could have been just like a cousin of Danny Pink that just happened to look a little like him.
Twin cousin, with Martha Jones, like her twin cousin, something like that.
Yeah, but then he wouldn't get the soldier, and then she wouldn't give it to the Doctor, and the Doctor would be a warrior, not a Doctor.
Yeah, unless it probably passed through since Danny Pink died, maybe it was passed down to, you know, a family member, the closest relative to him.
I just unscrewed this up, I'm telling you.
That is a big plot point. Or plot hole.
Well, I'm just asking a silly question here, but tell me if I'm wrong, but, you know, after this next series, and say that there's no companions, would you like, in series 11, for him to have more than one companion, like how he did with Adric and that?
Well, the thing is that I just made a speculation, like, what if they just did no companions? But according to Moffat, there is going to be a companion, so...
But would you like there to be more than one?
I did. I actually would like him to have two.
Yeah, because, I mean, he looked like he looked more at home with more people around him than just one.
I feel if he had two females in there, totally different from each other, that would be enough story to
Rose and Martha. Like Rose and Martha.
Well, no. One would be like Ace, blowing stuff up and crazy and
opposite from her.
And one would be all like prison stuff or whatever.
Oh, or Jane.
Whatever. I mean, that was a bit word.
Anyway, they're gonna say that Sarah Jane's a property of K-9.
One's heavy metal and one is like opera or something.
Oh god, that'd be like
the Daleks, heavy metal.
They would have the girl with black hair, and she'd take his guitar and she'd start playing heavy metal with TARDIS.
Sam and Cat, the show Sam and Cat.
You play heavy metal.
One's a girly, a punk rocker chick, and then one's a girly girl.
No. She would play the heavy metal with the TARDIS. She'd grab the guitar. He's like, give me that. Like, you know. Sam is from iCarly, right? Isn't that, or is that different?
Sam and Cat. It was a spinoff of
from
iCarly. Victorious.
Yeah. Victorious, I think.
Okay.
And Cat was from Victorious,
So,
Cat's the girly girl, and Sam's the punk rocker chick.
Yeah, we need two companions for Capaldi, not one.
Yeah,
that's the budget.
That's what I mean. He seemed more at home with like more than one companion. With one companion, it's like he's worried about them all the time. But if there's two, then they don't have to worry as much, if you know what I mean.
They could have, like I said, the one that's like a heavy metal mischievous one that plants like a bomb underneath Davros' chair or something, and he's like, ah!
Whatever.
Like, but, the doctor need to have one rule for his new companions, though. They need to listen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly. Listen.
But you probably have rocket launchers. Yeah, they don't listen, though. Nobody listens.
Exactly. Yeah. I'd like to see another episode like where there's more than the five doctors again. Like there's different doctors again.
I would see one companion have a rocket launcher and the other one have a nail file. I would just do that. That would be I think that would be pretty funny. I don't know.
Or the doctor hang out with the Pastor Noster gang.
Yeah, why not? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Or go back to the Happiness Patrol.
Oh, Candyman, absolutely. Hmm. Why can't they do that?
That's what I mean. I'm not even rude. Moffat's going back, maybe re-watching episodes, because he's got the Sea Devils back. So why can't he get someone else like that back?
Could somebody send Moffat some videos that would make good episodes, and then like hopefully we'll get a different...
Yeah. And then we'll just send him one back of like the five Doctors and say, can you reboot it with like this Paul McGann onwards?
They should have a reality show, What Moffat Watches. That's what it should be called. What does Moffat watch?
Or what does the Uvians want?
Like and have more Doctor, the fourth Doctor episodes than me. Because this series has been kind of four Doctor-ish a little bit.
Oh, yeah. And you're always having this banana daiquiri, because bananas are good.
Exactly.
Yeah. I don't know, man. All right, so we only got this Saturday, and then it's over until Christmas.
Boo.
And then it's over for a very long time, possibly.
Yeah.
Why? Apart from us, what we're watching every episode till when it comes back on.
Then we're out of work, gang. Well, not really.
So this right here, this last episode will be a game changer, right?
Oh, every episode's a game changer.
Muppet's a gender change.
The hype is always higher than the reality.
Next, we'll probably hear Moffat say that Wither's a man.
Well, they said that something happens in this episode that is going to split the fan base.
Right.
Really? What are you going to do, reverse the polarity?
Meaning that...
Well, I'm the neutron flow, yeah.
Some people are going to stay, some people are going to go. Split. What could they do to make it split down the middle?
I wonder.
Change the doctor into a teenager or something, or what?
Maybe no. Help us not turn him into a woman.
they're gonna create a Whovian civil war amongst everybody because.
Like we need any more.
That's classic, Gloria. Classic.
I didn't mean it like that. Thank you for the update, Gloria. But anyway.
Well, hang on. What, James?
He's gonna be the hybrid.
No.
As long as they don't say that the doctor was the gopher from Caddyshack.
A
Time Lord was bored, and they just went.
The doctor's Happy Gilmore.
I mean, I don't want to see like anything crazy. Like the Time Lords are really humans, and
we descend from them.
Or Omega's coming back.
Where they're apes, I guess. What could they do?
Or they're ours, actually.
Hang on.
Gloria, what could they do?
What if the Time Lords controlled by the Daleks?
No.
Daleks.
It's got to be something associated with the classic series, because it's splitting it from this era. Right,
in other words, Moffat is going to dump on the classic series.
Yeah. He's big time, it looks like.
A huge neutron flow on the classic series.
Right.
Like, I'm talking big polarity there. So, what is he going to do? The classic series that's gonna split us.
Why?
Or put them in a hole.
So basically, what you're saying is that they're going to probably split it to where the ones who like the classic will go back with liking the classic, and the new who will like the new who. Or do you think it will be just like sliced in half because of just overall everything.
Well,
I hope he doesn't do anything that makes it to where I don't like the classic anymore, because I love the classic too.
Well, yeah. Well, what did I'm not being rude, but what did Albert say that it was that you'd like the classic lot?
His source, he can't reveal because of his source, because his source was watching.
Albert in here so you can talk for himself. And then if he wants to talk, he can talk. If not, you know, then he could say my source said I can't talk or whatever.
Well, the only thing I can think of would be making the Doctor half human, because not a lot of people like that.
Like that idea, yeah.
Yeah.
That's the only thing I can think of.
Yeah.
He was born on Earth and he got and he are two Earth parents, and then they got
by the Gallifreyans.
Yeah. Yeah. That could be something that splits it.
No, it's gotta be something that's gonna piss us off.
Yeah.
So, but if it's what Albert's saying, and it's something that from the classic series that we'll love, and it's not that bad, then what the hell could it be? It's gotta be something. So let's just go through it. He had 7 regenerations in, oh well, 8 if you count the movie from the classic lot. Could they say that one of them wasn't really the Doctor, and that the second Doctor was really the first Doctor?
Well, if they said that the first Doctor was like the 17th Doctor, I'm done. Because I don't want to hear that.
That's what I mean.
Say that William Hartnell was not the first Doctor.
Patrick Troughton was. And Patrick Troughton. Or the one, hang on, or they say that when they forced Patrick Troughton to change into John Pertwee, and that's the first Doctor, that could piss him off.
Well, they could say that he's the Master and then he's just the Doctor after, which that would piss me off too.
Yeah, because I'm not being rude. They forced that on him, didn't they?
Make the Master him. Make the Master the same character. That would be terrible.
Yeah. Well, we're starting to get some kind of idea.
Like the Master is the Valiar.
No.
Yeah.
That would be terrible.
Well,
that'd be like making Roman.
There's gonna be a Doctor that gets really pissed off. He starts cutting his arms and his legs off, and then he regenerates. And like he's making cupcakes, with regeneration. He makes like 5 of himself.
Yeah, but it's funny though, isn't it? That when in that episode, Twilight Time Lord, the Master told the Doctor that the Valyard was the Doctor, and he already knew him.
Yeah. Unless so they make it like, if they make it like he, if they make it like he's Jesus Christ, it's over. I said that already.
Yeah.
Well, here's the thing too. He confessed pretty much that he didn't leave Gallifrey because he was bored.
Was he scared that the Time Lord was getting too much power?
And if he's a hybrid, wouldn't his granddaughter be like a super duper hybrid mixed of like different sugar, spice, and everything
that's like what I was saying on yesterday's episode, weren't I? I was saying we don't even know who she is really, because after the William Hartnell, there's nothing else to do with her.
If you have a hybrid, slow down. If he's a hybrid, then she's like sugar, spice, and everything nice, mixture of super hybrid, because how many different races are in there now to make up Susan?
And then she stayed on Earth and married a human.
And then she just totally screwed up the gene pool.
Yeah. Oh, don't tell you that I'll say that I'm not Clara was his daughter. or something like Susan gave birth to Clara.
Or Clara's mother.
We're getting ridiculous. We know Clara's mother. We know who Clara's mother is.
Yeah. Her mother is.
Yeah, we know that her mother was buried 6 feet under. We don't know exactly who or where she died.
I never saw Amy Rory become Cyberman. That's all I have to say. All right, no way. Let's just calm down. God. Let's calm down. Take it down, Matt.
At this rate, we'll say that Sally Sparrow is Clara's mother.
Watch out now.
No.
Watch out now. Let's relax. Let's breathe.
Listen to Dr. Joel.
Clara is not a balloon. Clara's not a buffoon.
Oh, I thought you said balloon.
Clara is not a Dalek. Clara is not water, which I thought she turned into water when she cried, which was, that was crazy in itself.
Like, she's not a raven. She's not a raven.
She's not a ganger.
Clara is
Oswin.
Yep,
he's Equidana. Clara is Oswin.
Let me think.
Clara is Kylo Ren!
Well, it's something different.
Okay.
No, did Clara we see Ronnie?
Wait, did we see Wait, did what? We see Clara's mother pop that baby out? Not really.
No.
That's what I'm saying.
I don't really want to see that, to tell you the truth.
That's
a little graphic for Doctor Who, don't you think?
That'll be season 15.
You know the part when Clara's mother, when she was like being held by her father in the room and her mother came in and looked at them? Well, there was a basket next to her father. I always thought that's the kind of basket you would put on a doorstep if you leave a baby.
Are you thinking about Moses and stuff? I'm thinking about
and Harry Potter. Harry Potter.
Wait a minute.
You know how that was the basket that little Sweet Pea was in? Kind of reminded me of
Chris,
that.
Chris is saying something. Oh, don't jinx it. Don't jinx it, Chris.
No, slow down. One at a time. Chris.
What if Clara, right, was brought to them by a Time Lord stork?
Oh, no.
What are we going to happen?
Oh, Lord.
She's the Smurfette of the Gallifreyan village. Is that what you're saying?
Well, hang on. If let's just think about it. Clara was brought to the doctor by the master or Missy.
Yeah.
So obviously somewhere.
I don't believe that either. First of all, that didn't happen because he met her as Oswin first.
Yeah.
So
what else? That noise. I just thought I heard something fall over somewhere.
Sorry about that.
He met her as Oswin first. He met her second as the nanny in the Snowmen. And then he met her a third time, which, you know, okay. Even if she didn't give her the number, I felt that they would have met. Just like Don and Opal didn't need Dalek Khan to push them together because they were going to meet anyway. He just sped up the process, so.
The only bit I laughed at was that the previous Clara episode was that when she said about Soufflé Girl, like Oswin.
Yeah.
Because
she heard about the souffle girl from the doctor, and she's like, she was making it, and her charges said, "Oh, you make another souffle?" She's like, "Yeah, and this time I will be souffle girl because she's heard about the souffle girl." Yeah.
But at that time,
she didn't know she was the same as the souffle girl. She didn't know she was Oswald. She just like wanted to be as good because she heard about the way the doctor kept mentioning this. You know, how she remembered, I don't even remember if she remembered him talking about, you know, the times that he saw or came across her before.
Okay, let's just figure this out. Is Clara's part of the equation, obviously?
Yeah, there's something, I'm still saying, even after her death, I still say there's something iffy about the whole thing.
Okay.
We still got Time Lord Clara still on Gallifrey, right?
In all seriously, what James just said, what if Clara, the Time Lord version of her, is that woman that contacted Wilf?
Right.
Yeah, maybe. Instead of his mother.
But he recognized her because he remembered her from the 50th.
Well, we don't know if the doctor recognized that woman. We just all assumed that he recognized her.
He recognized her.
He looked at her, but we don't know if he actually recognized her.
He knew her.
Yeah. Because in the end of time also that them Time Lords were like weeping angels.
Well, she covered her face like an angel.
Yeah. That's what I mean. But hang on. Think about it. There's a link there, isn't there? Them Time Lords covered their faces like an angel. And then in this episode coming up, there's pictures of angels.
Yeah. angels of old or something like that.
Yeah. Would that be their punishment, to turn them into a weeping angel, the Time Lord done, when the Master got stepped in the way of Rassilon?
So I just don't understand, why would you create something to split the fan base where you don't want them to watch Doctor Who?
They're trying to kill it! They're trying to kill it!
Like, because they need to get a new showrunner.
If you wanted it cancelled, you would say that the Doctor's a Teletubby or something. I mean, like, you
wouldn't... No, I was drinking!
I don't want to know that bit.
Listen, or you would have him have an outfit that's more extravagant than the sixth, if you wanted to get canceled. But expecting someone else, it's like, you know, no.
What like Ronald McDonald Whovian or what?
Jar Jar Binks.
I mean,
he's gonna regenerate into Jar Jar Binks.
Wait, Moffat doesn't. What is the goal with Moffat? What is the let's think like a Moffat. Can we think like a Moffat? Somebody get a. Let me curl my hair for a second. No.
We can try.
Get out of my eyes.
Let me think.
Okay, let's get into Moffat mode. Yeah. Okay.
Right.
Okay.
Stop. Boy, how am I gonna piss people off today?
I'm gonna rewrite this for the
really good. Really
Neil Gaiman, get your good ideas out of here. Screw you.
Yeah. I'm gonna have the Doctor have no TARDIS.
You got Moffat to the T. I got one of those for my birthday, Joe. My
Russell
birthday.
Davis, fuck off. I want my show.
Whoa.
Get the spoonheads, people.
Hang on.
Why?
First eight Doctors.
Yeah, but... Let's start from when it first come back on the TV with Christopher Eccleston, with a Moffat kind of...
You know what pisses everybody off?
What?
That the Doctor says, I'm not the Doctor.
And who would it be then?
Yeah. You mean he, like, decides to not be the Doctor?
No. That he's not the Doctor. And he hasn't been the Doctor since, like, the Eighth Doctor. Because the Eighth Doctor that drank the potion isn't the real Eighth Doctor, because the other Eighth Doctor is dead, or that's like a clone or something, because... And that all those Doctors after are not really the Doctor.
That could be something. But then who would it be? Who would it be then?
Renegade Time Lords or what?
If they said the Doctor's in the Doctor, that would flip everybody. Okay, you know, this is it. Spectacular Spider-Man 226, they said that Ben Reilly the clone was the real Peter Parker, and the Peter Parker we read about for 15 years was the clone, okay? It split the entire Spider-Man fan base in half. Half the population of Spider-Man fans gave the finger and left, okay? I stuck with it. We had a clone in the Spider-Man comic for like 2-3 years. They even had Peter Parker slap Mary Jane to say that he was the clone because the real person would not slap his wife, okay?
Wow.
So that split the fan base. Right? Then they fired the original writers. And they didn't know how to solve it. So for 3 years, it was a mess. Okay? They finally tried to fix it, and they said, oh, yeah, Peter Parker was chilling in Canada with Mary Jane, and that was really him. And the clone got killed by the original Green Goblin that they brought back to life after 15 years. But besides that split the fan base in half.
Oh, my gosh.
So if you say... that Doctor number 9, 10, 11, 12 are not the Doctors, or you even say that the, you know, after it's, 7, it's not really, or whatever.
It would be like that everything that we thought
guys.
The new Who okay. has been a dream. It'd be the same as that. It would be seriously.
Ripping off Dallas episode.
So the Dream Lord had been taken him over by at some time earlier than.
It would be like Amy being replaced as a ganger only for like 10 years.
Yeah.
So hang on, if that's the case, then I'm not being rude. Then in the God Complex, you'd see the real him.
I'm just a suspect. Listen.
I'm saying.
Yeah. We're speculating what could piss off the fan base. If they go with the Spider-Man thing. Did you guys talk? Yes, we did. We did, Albert, but we're trying to talk about this right now. One second, we'll go back to it.
Okay.
We're trying to figure out, and I said, if they go with a Spectacular Spider-Man 226, where the clone was the real Spider-Man, and that split the Spider-Man fan base. If they do that, that would stop Doctor Who. We would all be, like, divided completely. Now, they also did another event in the Spider-Man comic to split the fan base, where they had Peter Parker make a deal with the devil to save Aunt May's life.
Oh,
when she was almost 100 years old.
One more day.
She got shot by the Kingpin sniper, and he wanted to save an 100-year-old Aunt May. So to do that, he would spit on his marriage, his holy marriage to Mary Jane, where it never happened for 21 years our time, but a couple of years their time. And he was not, no great power comes great responsibility, no sense of responsibility. He did the most selfless, he crapped on his wife, and the devil got the soul of his child because she was pregnant or whatever. So, and then he just woke up in Aunt May's attic having her wheat cakes, and he had no marriage to Mary Jane. It never happened. Okay? That pissed off the fan base in half, again, twice. So all you have to do is screw with the character, and you say, like, say he's a mass murderer, and then he became the doctor after he killed, like, a whole universe, or that this whole universe.
This way, all we could, or if they say that the doctor is still a kid and it's all a dream in his head.
Like he wakes up in the barn.
Say elsewhere.
Yeah. That could split the universe.
You know what they could do? You know, honestly, like, I'm being serious here. You know what they could do?
Don't jinx it.
You know how... I'm jinxing it. You know how in the trailers we've seen the Doctor says, I haven't even, like, started, or I haven't gone far enough yet, or something like that?
Yeah.
What if at the end of this episode he decides to become the Valyard, and that's the cliffhanger, and then people are like, wait, the Doctor's evil? And then what happens is... The fan base is split. The classic fans are like, yeah, the Valyard, but the new fans are like, the Doctor's evil? This is stupid.
And all the adventures of Series 10 is...
Or the Valyard.
No, is him past episodes where
that.
Leading up to that.
I don't think they would do that, though. I think that they would continue on from what they did, and people would be pissed off.
So what you're saying, let's just get this... That Tardai, where he escaped from, is actually going to be the Valyard's Tardai.
So the Valyard Okay, well...
Because I'm not even... He's got a connection with his own Tardis, the Doctor, so he'll need a new one for the Valyard. The one which he ain't got a connection to.
The regular Tardis will not do anything for the Valyard.
That's what I mean.
It's still on Earth, too.
That's what I mean, so he'll need a new one.
So you're saying he becomes the Valyard at the end of the finale, and then just see a flashback for the Christmas.
Think about it, right? If they were to say that the hybrid is the Valyard, right? Somehow, like him becoming the Valyard makes him a hybrid or something. What if? Because I really think this could split the fan base. Because, like, while the classic series fans would be like, "Yeah, this was gonna happen. This is amazing." The new fans would be like, I don't know who the Valyard is, and this is stupid that the Doctor, the guy that they've been rooting for the past 10-plus years, is like the new villain, and he's worse than before. And they're like, this is dumb.
I'm a classic series fan, and I wouldn't want him. I want to see the Valyard come to be, but I wouldn't want it to be with his new home.
Yeah, because I'm not being rude. In this
era... I always thought it would be a separate... I don't know. I mean, it said that he is like the personification of all his evil side or his bad side come together. I thought he would always regenerate, and then whenever he finished regenerating, they would be two people standing there, an evil version of himself and a good version of himself.
Yeah, I thought that
was going to be him turning into something completely different.
No, but remember what he said in Face the Raven, though. He was yelling at a shield, he said, the Doctor's not here.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
So if he's still, and he's obviously still pissed that Clara's dead. Now, okay, the thing that trumps this is we've seen the scenes in the barn where he like we think that the barn is the end of or not the barn, the diner. Where we think that's the end of the episode. But if we've been misled this whole time, which we have been before on this show, that might not be the ending of the episode. The episode might be ending with him literally flipping out, or maybe he does split somehow. Maybe that regeneration that guy is screaming about in the thing.
Well, wait a minute. They said they made a call to stop the regeneration.
Right.
So they stop it halfway and it creates the value.
Well, it could be. It could take away his regenerations, and then those regenerations spawn into the Valyard.
Yeah, because like I was trying to say yesterday, I read on a site, I can't remember which one, but when in the classic series, it was explained that the Valyard was on a planet, a Tolpol sign, something beginning with E, and he was they had no regenerations left with the Doctor, and he was trying to break the cycle of the 13 regenerations, which was put on by the Time Lords.
Valyard needs regenerations to continue.
Yeah, and he was trying, I'm not being rude, and he was trying to find a way where he can break that cycle, and it's gone wrong, and he's got put into a shadow house, and then he's picked up by the Time Lords.
Sort of what the Metacrisis Doctor has no regenerations.
Exactly, so it could be him trying to find a way to break the cycle, and just saying, because that's what I've read. That's what I read on the site yesterday, and that's what I was trying to say in yesterday's episode.
So we're saying either he's not the Doctor, which would piss us off.
Yeah.
Him becoming the Valyard, would that piss us off, or would it be like
it wouldn't?
It'd be a long time coming.
It wouldn't piss the classic fans off, but and this is the thing, right?
There's more kids watching this kind of era Doctor.
Right. The new fans are more likely to come back to the show than the classic fans. Because think about this. If you piss the classic fans off enough, they stop watching.
Right.
But the new fans will be like, I'll give it a shot. Why not?
I got to say, from my kids' perspective, they're already at that point where they're not watching what it's
exactly.
So
think about this, too. If the ratings are starting to go down, what better way to have a cliffhanger where the Doctor snaps and turns evil? And then the next season, people are like, I gotta see this.
So let me get this. Here's the thing. Then this is what they do. Okay. They said that you died billions of years ago, right?
Right.
So if they create the Valyard and their Time Lords are screwed, then they would undo him getting teleported to that hell prison.
Right. Yeah.
And he would never copy himself a billion times, and you would have an anomaly, which that's what the Valyard is. The Valyard's like a complicated space-time event anomaly.
Yeah, which the Doctor creates himself.
So basically, they created their own hell, and the only way to fix it is to save the Doctor and prevent him. And that's how he doesn't really go to Gallifrey. Like, in other words, they would prevent him from going to the trap. And he would be teleported in the diner instead of
the trap.
That's it.
Yeah.
That's it. Wait a minute. That's it.
What?
That's it. He's going to be teleported in the diner instead of Heaven Sent episode, because the Time Lords are going to undo it.
So basically, he's tortured, seeing Clara one last time.
And the Valyard's going to escape through time before he gets erased, because if he's in a time machine, he won't get erased, because he's like an anomaly.
And he goes into Tardis and escapes.
What if the diner is a TARDIS?
No.
We talked about Chris said that the other day.
Yeah.
And I don't think it's the same diner from The Possible Astronaut.
Yeah.
Yeah. So basically, in the last few episodes, we've had the lines where I will rain hell on you to a shielder, and the Doctor's no longer here. In Heaven Sent, we've had I'm the Doctor and I'll never ever stop looking for you, and Clara told me to not look for you, and I'm lying sometimes, and I tell you I'm lying sometimes. And in Hellbent, it's where he's died a billion years ago, or whatever, if it's that to him,
or he's talking about Gallifrey, that that you'd all died a billion years ago, and I stopped it, but I'm not going to stop it now. And it ends on him punching the general and escaping. That could do it.
You know what they could do? They could show stuff we didn't see behind the scenes from Peter Capaldi, that he threw the half mace man off the building, and then we could see behind the scene things, like he'll go back to certain things he did, and he'll kill like this villain or the Weeping Angel or whatever, like, and we're like, we didn't even see that part of him, and then he becomes the Valiant. But I don't think they'll do that. But
I think what they should do is they should hold off on the Valyard until the regeneration episode. That'd be perfect.
So we're thinking it's the Valyard thing, because that would make sense. And then the Time Lords are screwed, and they have to revert time to prevent him from going to that prison they put him in the first place.
Yep.
And they zap him at a still point in time. Later, James. They drop him off at a still point in time, because they need to make him fixed that he doesn't go to that prison. So that's what they would do. That would be the way to fix it. They drop him off at a still point in time.
Yeah. Or in this episode, he's on 12 regenerations now, isn't he? He's on his 12th incarnation.
Yeah, he's his 12th incarnation.
Right. So right. What happens, so if they say, right,
13th body, but yeah.
And they take out all the rest of the regenerations that they gave him, but keep him as number 12, And then he goes and off on that trance, and then goes to that planet for the next series and tries to break the cycle.
He worked so hard to get him regenerations, Moffat. They're not going to take away his regenerations.
But that's the only way. I'm not even rude. That's the only way to link it with the classic Who for the Valyard. Because if they say that the Time Lord's done it, then that's basically shitting on them.
Well, if they stop the regeneration, then the Valyard is like almost like a Metacrisis Doctor, where you know he is half of. He's part of the Doctor, but he needs some DNA to become whole. So he uses the General's DNA that got punched, or the President's DNA, and he merges with him.
Oh, the General was awesome. I loved him.
Well, that's what they'll probably do. They'll probably have the Doctor part regenerate with the General and become the Valuer.
Oh,
and then he doesn't have any more regenerations. Yeah.
At this rate, we'll probably see, it wouldn't surprise me, like I said yesterday, that David Tennant, that he'll turn into one of his old regenerations, and if it's David Tennant, then it could be the Metacrisis Doctor one.
Right.
And then he could say, I'm back.
What's up, Albert?
You know in the trailers where it showed the Doctor talking to Ashilda?
Yeah.
What if the Time Lords awarded her with something?
The TARDIS?
Who knows?
She wants the TARDIS.
Maybe they gave her regenerations.
Yeah, maybe they gave her regenerations.
And they gave her a name.
But she don't need regenerations. She don't die.
Or they take that away from her and say, ego, you can have this instead.
No, maybe they give her a Time Lord brain. Where she could just hold all those memories. Right? She don't have to need a diary anymore. All right, so, Albert, what did you want to say about the Christmas special? I know we've been going on and on and on, but...
So you guys already talked about it, right?
Yeah.
The husbands of River Song?
Yeah, the girls believe that it's the Doctors as the husbands.
All the different faces, because he's the same character, just with different faces. So right. It's like a cool way of saying.
So if she has her own like little picture book, she have a picture with David Tennant, a picture with the 11th, a picture with the like all the Doctors.
That would be amazing.
It'd be amazing if she had the diary as well, like from the Titles of Library.
Yeah.
Like I then just said, oh, well, I've done this now. You saved me here. I'll see you next time.
I think they're gonna be more in line this time. I don't think it's gonna be like, well, maybe on her, maybe a little more. Than him, but I think for him, he'll be like, right, kind of, sort of. What do you think, Joe? Do you think they're going to be more, like, going the same way, not, like, opposite directions and stuff?
I think, here's the thing. This is after Angels Take Manhattan.
Yeah.
We don't know how many more adventures she's got left.
Yeah.
So, once she dies, then she's in line. I mean, that's what it was in the name of the Doctor.
Yeah.
But technically, she needs two journals because her last adventure in with the Doctor was the last page was Silence of the Library and Forest of the Dead. But then she had an adventure with the name of the Doctor, which that's just technically another journal.
Yeah, true.
Yeah. Because even though she wasn't there, she was there.
She's not an echo. That's her in the Silence of the Library. That's ridiculous. He's just trying to make himself feel better. The new one, the one
for this episode, the Christmas episode, is not going to be an echo of her, like, after the library. It's actually probably before, maybe.
Yeah.
It could be after she's rescued from the library, because, you know, the audio version.
She's rescued from the library.
Yeah.
I also think that Capaldi's new Sonic is awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah, we like it, man. We like it a lot.
I can't wait to see
it. I'll buy it as soon as it comes on Amazon.
So,
I can't wait for that episode like crazy.
Quick question. Do you think, where do you think she gets the Sonic from this Doctor? In the next series or in the Christmas special?
Capaldi gives it to her in Series 11.
Yeah.
I don't think he's leaving. I don't think he's leaving either.
Me neither. No.
But I think he'll do specials after this.
I think he's going to do series
11. Ripper may even be in more episodes than just the Christmas, because their chemistry is so great.
When they do the Singing Towers, that's when Moffat leaves.
Yep, I'm pretty sure of it. Since Ripper was his first creation as one of his major creations for the show, like, I think it would be appropriate if he leaves when the character River leaves. So,
when he leaves, that's going to be the Singing Tower.
And it will be a tear fest.
Fine. Quick question. So, do you think the Singing Towers could be also Clea Capaldi's last episode before he regenerates into 13?
Yes.
Because I'm not being rude. She said in the Science of the Library, she said he was crying that day like he knew that war was coming. And that's what might make him into the Veil Yard. That's what might keep him into the Veil Yard, because it's upsetting him that he's losing too many people, because he said it himself.
Yeah.
I could tell you that he's going to regenerate into like a 20-year-old. Honestly.
So we're going to have another Matt Smith then, another young doctor.
They're going to recapture the Rose Doctor thing, but only they're both going to be 20-something years old, and it's going to be like some young love thing. I'm telling you, that's what they're going to... That's the direction they're going to go.
Yeah.
I'm going to make a prediction, all right? I'm going to predict the guy that does Class is going to be the showrunner of Doctor Who. He's going to have the Doctor 20 years old in love with his companion, and then we'll probably even get married. And he's going to do that because he's good at young teenage, young adult novels.
I'd rather have Mark Gatiss as showrunner.
I'm predicting that's what's going to happen. It's going to be a totally different dynamic. They're prepping him now with Class. I'm telling you, he's going to be the showrunner.
Do you think that whenever River, like you said, the Singing Towers and stuff, that's actually before she goes to the library. Since she does get rescued from the library, do you think she has regenerations after that? Where she can regenerate too and be younger? Like, so that way it's no longer Alex Kingston, but a younger actress.
Well, the question is, right?
Did she burn out the cycle from the thing?
What the question is, when Harold Saxon was revived, did he get completely revived where he got his regenerations back? Or did he not?
I don't think so, because he was a skeleton.
So, I don't know about that, but the Master has been a worm. Or whatever. He's found a way to regenerate without regenerations.
The 13th Doctor. I'm not being rude. The 13th Doctor. I'd so love it if they chose a ginger one, because he always wanted to be ginger, didn't he?
He's not going to be ginger.
I know, but you know what I'm saying.
I'm telling you, he's going to be 20 in his 20s, and so is the companion. I'm telling you right now, they're going to go for the Shadowhunter, Twilight, friggin' Class. I'm telling you, because we're too old. That's what they're gonna do. We're too old, aren't they? They don't care. I mean, that's what they're gonna do. They're gonna make it a young All the fangirls, here, here's the door. Here's it, it's open now. Come back in. That's what's
coming in
be.
2019.
Yeah, the fangirls will come in and the golden girls will go out. That's what's going to happen. It's like, it's going to be a young show, 20s. The doctor is going to literally be 19, 20 years old. The actor. The actor is going to be like 19, 20.
It just makes me laugh, though, whenever I hear that he always wanted to be ginger. I don't know why, but it always made me laugh. I'm not ginger, for heaven's sakes.
But we'll see that eventually. But I'm honestly, I think the doctor is not going to be ginger. He's going to be, even the, I think the actress is going to be older than the doctor a little bit. But I think that's what's going to happen. They're going to get a 19, 20-year-old, and they're going to get a 22-year-old companion, and that's what's going to be.
I'd like to see like another Jamie comeback.
Yeah.
Because I'm not even with that. Another bloke with him, it's like, he's always had women now, so a bloke would be a change, wouldn't it?
I think it would be good to do that, but I think in this type of demographics, I think people want to see the doctor with a female, like opposite sex.
Yeah, a sexy hot female, yeah. That's the only trouble.
I mean, the doctor can be like, I don't know. I mean, but the thing is, I think that's what they're going to go for, like a younger version David Tennant look type of thing. That's what they're going to do. What was he, Casanova? What was he before that? He was, what was he? But, like, that's what they're going to do.
Hamlet. He was Hamlet, weren't he?
Yeah, but they're gonna go for that. They're going to go for that young. Yeah. And they're going to have, that's going to be like that for at least 10 years, I think. So, you know.
As long as we don't get a doctor which wears a leather jacket like Chris Eccleston and getting it, because that makes him look like he's a T-Bird.
We may even see, yeah, T-Bird. Like
come on. Yeah, oh, come on. I've just come from the Time War and I want to be Grease Lightning. God.
The doctors can be like, go and drive me.
That's going to be Capaldi's farewell song. I'm Grease Lightning. Go, Grease Lightning.
God.
I predict Capaldi's last episode. I predict Capaldi's last episode will be the 11th planet.
God. The what? Yeah, the 11th planet, yeah, that's cute.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, as long as I don't have the doctor on a motorcycle with a cigarette in his
mouth. or in the grease car going, yeah, I'm going back in time, baby.
like cigarettes kill, but not me.
Sonic cigarettes.
Or you'll be in a DeLorean and say, I'm going to go meet Doc Browner. I've heard he's cool.
I don't want to give anybody ideas. We don't need to have the doctor like he's 20 years old with like a motorcycle.
Well, don't say that, Joel, because I've not been with Moffat's urge you before, because you kind of said about the Sea Devils and all of a sudden they turned up.
We've been talking about the Sea Devil for
3 years.
We
do not want that.
Yeah, but you know what I'm saying.
That, but, yeah.
I know. I get my wish and then I get mad that I get my wish. That's a sad thing.
Yeah. So what you should do is reverse psychology, Joe. Say what you don't want so he will do it.
I'm an ungrateful, spoiled little brat.
Say what you do want and pretend like you don't want it so that way he'll do it.
Yeah. We should all just write into the Stephen Moffat and say, listen to this cast.
All right. I do want Sea Devils. I want the Jaggeroth. I want a season without the Cybermen. Okay, a Dalek has to appear. Okay, he can.
Candyman. Candyman. Yeah.
You can have Captain Jack. You can have the Dalek doorman. Okay, whatever. Just have him there for a couple seconds.
Yeah, the Dalek bouncer. Get out.
Want some tea? No. Okay. Honestly. I want to have a season because I want them to develop the villains. I want them to develop Sea Devils, Silurians. I want another clone batch of Centaurans where they're tough and they're tall. I want to have like a Robotech size Centauran where they're like 8 foot or 10 foot tall Centauran. Okay, where they're actually a threat and you're scared. Like, turn the Centaurans, a clone batch, into friggin' huge monster Centaurans. Where they're so big you can't even reach the back of their neck. Okay?
I need to find another way.
That would be amazing.
I want bounty hunters to go after the Doctor because they're pissed off. They're pissed off that he screwed around with the memory banks of all their computers. I want to see people pissed off that he did that.
I want to see the boneless back.
I want to see quite a few things back, but I also want to know what the relationship was between him and Madame, what's her name?
The other one
with the green head. Yeah, Kaverian and also Madame Vastra.
Madame Kaverian's probably the new companion. A young Madame Kaverian. She'll probably be with a 20-year-old doctor. You won't know her name is Kaverian. You'll just know her first name.
And then
I'll wait until like the very last episode.
She could be a love interest. They get close and he cuts her off and then she gets scorned.
And that's how she hates him.
Yes.
That would be interesting. And I also want to know what the relationship between him and Madame Vastra, because that never really went deep, did it?
Because that you can't really do because the relationship's with Matt Smith. So I wouldn't, that's the way I envision it.
Yeah, unless they bring out audio stories with Matt Smith to explain it in time.
I mean, here's the thing. We have a wonderful audio set of Donna Noble and the Tenth Doctor, and we can't even have episodes about it. I wish we did because it sounds so fantastic, and we can't get that. I mean, it's really, if I was them, I would secretly film it, just like episodes of it, and just like release it later on because that's amazing.
Yeah, set it up to where if you're a subscriber, you get one set of audio dramas, and when you're not, you get the regular set.
Well, I would have it where you think it's an audio, but then you find out it's actually episodes.
Yeah.
So you're waiting for an audio set, and you find out, oh my god, it's the whole series.
Yeah, and I don't know if it was the BBC or nothing. Have nothing to do with it. It's just their own company.
It'll be like Russell T. Davis's productions or something.
Yeah.
Well, we didn't even talk about Peter Jackson. Peter Jackson's going to be basic. Well, we did talk about it a little bit, but Peter Jackson's going to direct Series 10, one of the episodes.
Yeah, he will. I'm so excited.
I think I'm saying it's a Sea Devil episode.
Sea Devil, yeah. Maybe they can bring back Captain Jack finally.
I'm saying he's directing a two-part Sea Devil.
As long as we don't see King Kong.
Here's the thing,
Jackson did one involving the Draconians and Daleks again.
Here's the thing, guys. I think we need to continue with two-parters.
Yeah.
But not the entire season.
Yeah.
Oh, I agree with that.
I could have the opening episode could be one part.
Aw.
Yeah.
I mean, we don't have to have an opening two-parter.
No, we could have one part, and then have a couple of episodes, then the second part of the first part.
The problem is we had a high. We had the greatest opener ever, and then all of a sudden, we fell flat.
And then until the cycle.
We need to keep the momentum going. We need to... You have to have a two-part seed up. Listen, the whole problem with the finale is... I didn't really feel that Face the Raven and Hellbent were kind of the finale. I mean, I didn't feel that Heaven Sent was a part of the finale to me. To me, Heaven Sent was like a turn left.
Yeah.
It wasn't really a part of the finale. I can't really count that as a two-part, and they don't really count it as a two-part.
No, finale. No.
In fact, if you notice, the only thing that's a real two-parter is the Zygons, the Fisher King and the opener, but all this other stuff is like, and I think we need to have a whole season where we can build up. That's the whole point. You got to build up. You can't keep reusing other people's stuff. You got to build up these other characters, these ice warriors, the great intelligence, bring them back, the Draconians. I mean, think about it. The Celestial Toymaker.
Oh, definitely.
The Meddling Monk. I mean, let's go already. Let's go already.
The Silent and the Headless Monks.
Listen, the Dream Lord. Throw this stuff in there unexpected, like, oh, the Whisper Men are back too. Like throw stuff in there. The what do you call it? The villains that were in Rings of Akatan. They were the coolest thing. The three of them. Bring them back. I mean, bring back somebody that's related to that. I mean, alien planets. Ood. Let's see some Ood.
Censorites.
Let's see Peter Capaldi versus the devil. I mean, how fantastic would that be?
That would be amazing.
He'd be screaming at the thing. The thing would be getting scared of him.
Yeah, especially if he's on the Time Lord Victorious and then goes into the Veil Yard.
You thought that David Tennant's eyes opening wide like that at the devil? Whoa! Like that? Just wait if Capaldi screamed at him. That'd be fantastic.
Asriel?
You know what I would like for Series 10?
I don't know, we're smacking him in the face.
I would like more linked episodes. I think the linked episode ideas was kind of underutilized this season.
Yeah. I would like to see this whole notion about King, after he loses Clara, he goes back to the past. He goes and revisits companions. Stop leaving it dead in the center. Go see Joe Grant. This is ridiculous. Why can't you go see classic companions? I don't understand that. Why can't
and
you
modern companions.
Why can't you shoot more for the classic? Because we've done too many of the modern.
Listen, I know I'm a classic Who guy too, but I put Joe Grant in like a couple episodes. Why not? What the hell would be the difference? She's fantastic, Katie Manning.
Bob Landian.
Put in some classic.
They could explain, and with Ace, they could easily explain that he had left her with Professor Chronotis, saying, "Yeah, I'll be back," but didn't tell her he was going to that trial. And then, of course, when he comes back as the new version, she finds out who he is. She's quite pissed off, like, "Why'd you leave me here?"
Right. You could have. What else could you do? You could even have him talk to his other selves in the TARDIS as like a hologram.
Yeah.
That
was home again.
Because I never did that. I mean, that's what they always had that emergency hologram thing. So why not?
In other words, he would hook himself up into this room, right? And it would basically be his other self inside of him talking, looking at that age. Like the Seventh Doctor being his age, like, you know, talking to him. That would be great. I think that would be fantastic.
That's the thing. We have all these great ideas ourselves, and yet Moffat doesn't even know one.
No, Moffat has great ideas, but the problem is he doesn't realize that they're other people's ideas, some of the stuff that he says. Some of the lines he repeats from other guys.
Yeah.
Like, oh, crap.
Oh, yeah.
He also doesn't know how to execute his ideas well.
Like, in other words, the whole joke about what are you going to do with the sonic screwdriver and build a cabinet, River said that. I mean, how many people said that already? The same joke three times, basically.
Hopefully the sonic screwdriver in the Christmas special can open wood.
Yeah.
But none should open wood, though. Wood is wood.
That's just stupid.
It's like, the classic, it's like the classic Green Lantern. His ring couldn't...
Right, the only thing open wood was a snowman episode, which they kind of slipped, I think, with that. But other than that, like, you can't open wood, basically.
Yeah, that's like the most retarded idea ever.
I would have an episode about that Russell T. Davis touched upon, where some things are deadlocked, meaning that people got wise about his stupid sonic screwdriver in their eyes, that they made things deadlocked, where the sonic screwdriver doesn't work. And that's why he has a problem if it's deadlocked. Even the TARDIS is deadlocked, too, sometimes. So who invented the deadlock? Probably one of his villains that got pissed off. You know?
Yeah, like the great intelligence or something.
I would revisit why that lady that with the adipose had a sonic pen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I would love to see classic Who villains come back, like the Sea Devils and Meddling Monk, etc. But also like to see like RTD characters like Captain Jack and Martha come back, so it can kind of connect Moffat and RTD's eras together. Because right now it's all kind of disconnected.
I would bring Adam the Companion back. Being
that would be hilarious.
Oh, yeah.
And then Peter Capaldi be like, "Who the hell are you?"
Jeopardy.
No, but I would have Peter Capaldi be like, "Who the hell are you?" And he's like, "You don't remember me?" Like, "No,
I'm too old."
Maybe we could bring back the Zorbalov.
He's like, "I don't remember you. Oh, I chose you as a companion. What the hell was I drinking?" Yeah. Yeah.
Maybe Adam turns out to be the Zorbalov.
Not only
Cliffhanger of Series 10.
The only thing I hate, I don't know about you, is I'm Kate Stewart. She's changed so much over these episodes lately.
Well, I want to ask Gloria, and I want to ask Sally about that. Kate Stewart was super strong in some episodes, meaning that strong character, didn't need anybody who's a rookie's opinion. Now, all of a sudden, she's gone back to the Power 3 type of thing, where she don't know what to do. She's asking Clara what to do. I mean, what's that about? Why did this happen all of a sudden, where Kate Stewart's becoming like a crappy character?
I don't know.
They turned her into crap.
It's like they don't know what to do with her anymore. Like,
that's what I felt.
I'd like the same way that went for Dad.
Well, hold on, Rick, because I want to get their opinion.
Sorry.
Yeah, Sally, honestly, do you feel the same way that they're ruining the character Kate Stewart?
Yeah, somewhat. Because, I mean, she had to be reminded, when they were talking about the plane, she's, worried about the people, which she should be, but she doesn't realize Clara's like, that's a lot of fuel. And you're like, she's like, well, yeah. Like, she didn't even think about that.
And what about they say little things like she had two daughters, right?
Did they recon that?
And even Osgood had a sister before she had a Zygon sister.
Yeah, so that's why we thought that they were her daughter.
I thought that at first,
yeah.
That Kate Stewart was the mother of Osgood or something.
Mm-hmm. That's what I thought. The first episode of the 50th, I thought that too.
I want there to be an episode where the Doctor has to stop this writer with an ego named Stephen Moffat from taking over the BBC with these shows, and then he's just a diabolical mastermind. That would be amazing. Well, Moffat could play the guy. That would be pretty cool. Well, I want to see Moffat play a guy that gets shot by the Dalek. That would be cool, too. That would be great.
I was also thinking, I said yesterday on my
We love Stephen Moffat. I joke around, but Moffat's a genius, and he does Sherlock, and he did Coupling and Jekyll and all these other wonderful things, and he comes out with some spanking great episodes, but then sometimes he comes out with these clunkers, which, if he's focused 100% on Doctor Who, I'm sure he'll come out with the Girl in the Fireplace type of caliber stuff,
I can't believe a few months ago we were giving him flack for working on Class because we were afraid that we were going to have specials.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. I'm still scared, Albert, about that. And I apologize to Mr. Class there, the guy, because I actually bought his book. I said I felt bad that we came down too hard. I mostly came down hard on him because we made it Moffat. But I'm a little scared about that series because I think Peter Capaldi's going to appear as a Doctor in a couple episodes or something. And what does that leave us,
Yeah, and I said yesterday that talked about John Pertwee being my doctor, kind of thing. He was a specialist in Aikido or something, weren't he? And that was the last doctor before now that was really violent towards an enemy. We should have that back in the doctor. That he's violent towards the enemies because they're trying to kill him and he wants to protect his own life.
He punches a Time Lord in the face, is that enough?
That's what I mean. But you know what I'm saying? Like, if he's like a Cyberman and that he doesn't care that he's gonna kill him, he just wants to do it.
I
because at the moment he's kind of like chicken. At the moment he's like, I want to talk to you. Can you just please leave?
He's so much better without Clara right now.
What I mean. That's what I'm trying to say. If he's that without Clara, but with a companion, he's like, oh, let me just talk to you. But talking doesn't always work, does it? Because someone always dies.
But that's why I want him without a companion for a little while.
Because then he can go back to
Because I like that, the way he acts. Like, he acts... All right, he could back off a little bit, but I like that strong doctor like that.
Yeah, that's what I like.
Like, they're worried that he's coming. Like, they're scared that he's coming. Like, he means business. They're looking out the window, they're like, oh, crap.
It's like the Pandora car opens. They were scared of the Doctor, and they all came for him to get locked in that thing.
They're afraid of the Doctor, but when they see his incarnation, they're like, oh, crap. crap.
That we got a 1-1. We got a 1-1.
No, now we're in trouble.
Hey, so, Joe.
Yeah.
I was watching your Peter Capaldi reaction video a couple days ago, and you're all talking about how you're super hyped for the 12th Doctor and stuff. So what is your opinion on the 12th Doctor so far?
Well, I do have to say that when we did the reaction, the job that I was working at, I was working like, and Scott will tell you, mm-hmm. especially with the unloading of the trucks and everything, I did like a double shift where I worked like in retail, like two doubles and got 3 hours sleep. So when I'm doing the 12th Doctor's reaction, I'm like a friggin' zombie where I'm like, I looked like I didn't care, but I'm like, I can't even move my... like I'm almost in the hospital, like I'm an old guy. I'm like, yay! Like last Joe. So I'm like, and people are like, you're not excited? I'm like, dude, I just worked like fucking 20 hours. Oh, excuse my language. Apologize. But like, nope. If you know, I used to work like unload trucks all the time. Like Scott, I mean, it's a pain in the you know what. Yeah, so I was unloading trucks, unloading, packing out. Pricing, putting up signs, storing them back in the stock room, and that's the job that I had. And then I got to see Doctor Who's reaction, and I still did the videos, as exhausted as I was. But I got heat for it because people are like, "You don't care, damn you, Matrix Lord, damn you! I'm as mad as hell, and I'm not gonna take any more. This guy don't give a." About Doctor Who. No, it's called I was tired.
It's called exhaustion and sleep drunkenness.
Yes. So to answer your question, I love Peter Capaldi. I want Peter Capaldi for like 10 years. I'm probably not going to get it, but if there is Peter Capaldi for 10 years, I want the Peter Capaldi that we see now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now. That's the one I wanted. That's the one I was dying for.
Not going to explain the explanation. It's just going to go, my words are your only warning now.
And you know what? I took a lot of heat for saying some episodes I didn't like with Capaldi, and I didn't mean that I didn't like Peter Capaldi, okay? But I love it how now, all of a sudden, right, out of the blue, all these people that like are from magazines and they're like every episode is perfect. Now all of a sudden they're like, oh, finally, the Doctor is the Doctor. Well, no shit, basically. That's what I've been fucking saying over and over for years, that all these idiots out there are like, Magic Slide hates. It's like, and they're like, Matrix Law don't like Doctor Who. Matrix Law don't watch Doctor Who. All sort of stuff. No, I want Capaldi like this. Yeah. This is how I would have Capaldi.
Yeah.
And you want Peter Capaldi like that, Albert. And you want Peter Capaldi like that, Gloria. And everybody and their mother wants Peter Capaldi.
Not this little afraid of his own shadow, afraid that if he moves a finger, he's going to
break him up. So, thank you, and you're welcome, because that's basically what I'm saying, okay? I got the Peter Capaldi that I wanted, finally. I took a lot of crap from people, but now people know what the F I'm talking about. This is the shit that I wanted. That's what I wanted. That Capaldi. I don't want do I save them? I don't know if I want to save them. Are you gonna die, Clara? I love you. I don't love you. I hug you. I don't hug you. What do I do?
Where's my card so I can...
I have a card to say I care about you. No. It's funny, but I want to see Capaldi. Look at when he was screaming at Clara. He's like, get it! Like, whatever. Like, yelling at her, right? You know, for some point in time, she became the whole show. Which, I love Clara, don't get me wrong, but it's Doctor Who, not Clara Who. Moffat turned it into a companion show where the Doctor lost focus. So now, of course, we don't have the companion, and everybody's like, 10 out of 10, yeah, thank you. Thank you, because if I was writing it, that's the way I would do it. That's what I wanted. And everybody's like, Major Slug, I don't know what he's talking about.
Well, I've got a question.
balls. Basically, what we're saying is we
want to have, I want it to balls. Be the beast. I want to be the beast.
Yeah.
Like he was supposed to be.
Yeah, because we had the storm. We had the oncoming storm with Kenan, ain't we?
The thing is, he could be the beast, right? But then he could be pleasant when you don't expect it. Like, he could be on there, they'd be like, oh, so how are you doing today? It's like,
oh, I'm good.
You can see him screaming. You can see him screaming at, like, parents, like, you just created the sea devils because they're alien sea monkeys, right?
Oh, hello
and then,
there.
And then, and he's like, you threw it in the water, you created this, and then you can see him being nice to, like, the kids. Like, I can see that. Like, just be terrifying with the villains, okay? No restrictions. Nobody tells him what to do because he's the friggin' boss, all right? He's the boss. Do you understand? The doctor's the boss. He's like strong, like Tom Baker. I do what I want. I go where I want. If you don't like it, I'll give you a flower pot and dump you in like five towns over. Like,
he get a mirror so people only see you from the corner of their eye.
Fine.
And he was so cool about it. He just dropped off people that he cared about, and it's like he didn't even shed a tear. And I was like, oh. Sarah Jane, he just dumped her outside. Like, oh. It's hey. Like, wow. You know?
Peace out, Sarah.
Yeah, peace out.
Yeah. All right. I've got
Joe Baker was the worst. He's like, oh, Perry, all right, thanks.
Joe, wow. Right. Everyone, this is for everyone. Right, what would be your dream episode? Like, if you had, if you were, like, the show runner, what would be your dream episode?
I want Omega. I want Capaldi with Omega and companions. Yens.
Yens. That's fine.
Right?
Right.
Anyone else? Susan. I want Susan. I want Ian Chesterton.
I want Ace. I want,
Vicky?
Yeah.
I want to see Peter Capaldi just go into Coalhill School, start screaming, where are you, where are you? Take the TARDIS and leave. Go up to Ian Chesterton's house. If you're the friggin' headmaster, why can't I find you in your own school? Like, I want to see like, something like that.
Yeah.
I want to see Susan. I want to see Tegan Chervanka.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I want to see Joe Grant.
Yeah, Joe. Oh, yeah, Joe.
Give me what I want, Moffat. Okay? Let me tell you something. You could throw Katie Manning in there for like three episodes, and you could have the highest rating.
Martha.
Better than any supermodel, hot 25-year-old. Katie Manning could sell it as how awesome she is as a companion. To friggin' just rock the ratings unbelievably because she's super intelligent and she's amazing. And you don't need to have glamour looks and like a 20-year-old supermodel. You can have the best of what came from before, okay? Katie Manning, two-parter with Capaldi. Thank you.
We don't want Doctor Who, the new series, to be a reunion show. That's basically In other words, where every time you turn on, it turns into the classic series. We just want our classic companions, our classic villains, to pop up every now and then. If not as part of the show, if not part of an actual episode, then do it as like, it's a crowd scene. So they pause the camera just right to where the classic companions go, there's that such and such, there's that such and such. And then move on.
I'm the type of fan, I get irritated. I get aggravated. I get pissed off when I get these stupid throwaway lines to the classic series as an insult in an episode that has nothing to do with the situation.
Yeah.
The hell with that. Give me classic companions and those classic villains in a freaking complete story. Don't give me a sentence. Don't throw away I don't want no more throwaway stupid lines, okay? Just give me a classic thing. I'm telling you, you do a good two-part Ice Warriors, people are going to go nuts, and then he's going to be like, oh, my God, I got to have to return like the Daleks. Yes, you do.
When the series first began.
Yeah, because I don't know about you guys. It's like every so often I'm like saying to myself, oh, it's Daleks again. It's Cybermen. Oh, yeah. I don't feel like watching it, but I've got to because it's Doctor Who.
How do you have a pair of balls? And I'm sorry for the R rating this episode, but how do you have a pair of balls and you give us a doctor we never heard of before? You take a friggin' risk that you don't know if you're going to piss him off. You undo the Time War, whatever. But then you can't do a two-part Ice Warrior episode. Mm-hmm. You can't do a Silly Devil episode. You can't do a Jaggeroth episode. Why can't you take a risk like that? Then take a stupid risk with a doc. I'm sorry, I love John Hurt, but I'm not happy about that whole... People know that. I'm not freaking happy about a doctor we've never seen before, Garbage. Yeah.
Well,
because Paul McGann ended the Time War in my brain, and that's the way it will always be.
When the series first began, I was thinking, oh, cool, every season they're going to throw in something new. Like, they're going to give you a classic companion, a classic villain, like they did with Gridlock or something like that. And that way, by the time the 50th came around, you got everybody caught up enough. But then they started doing the whole, let's create all these new ideas. Let's throw away the old stuff. Let's make it seem as though the current Doctor was responsible for the classic stuff that actually went on. And that's what...
Why can't you have the Mara? Why can't you have Cheek and Jovanka in a third-part Mara? Why not? Why can't you have...
Actually, it's so suppressed in her mind, something comes out and causes her to come back again.
Because why can't you special have... Effects, right. Special effects would be amazing.
Yeah.
Why can't you have a mistake that he made? Like, you left Perry with that Viking dude, and all her kids are nasty, evil people. Like, why can't you do that? I know you don't want to take away against the Perry companion.
Yeah.
But... there's got to be something that the Doctor screwed up, and now he has to deal with it.
Well, okay.
To have a villain companion would be... I'm telling you, I would do a Christmas special where Donna Noble's Scrooge, rich executive, and it's all because she doesn't have her memories, and then the Doctor has to fix it. And her. And why would it be outside? You said that there's no rules with Doctor Who, right? So why can't there be no rules? Why can't he go visit class companions? What's the friggin' problem? How could you have it where he keeps going to Earth every episode and bump into one of 1,000 companions that you had? You can't bump into not one damn companion?
Yeah, that's another thing I had a problem with when it came back on, is they constantly did the whole Earth adventure.
You shoved UNIT in our face, which I love UNIT, but where the hell is Mickey and Martha Jones?
Yeah, they were in it, weren't they?
Mickey and Martha Smith, or whatever the hell you're going to call her now.
Yeah, because they were in UNIT, weren't they?
Right, what the frick?
And Yates.
Yeah. It's like, I don't care about you now. But he saved them before he regenerated into the 11th. You can't forget about them that easy.
I just don't understand why are there rules with things that they don't need to be rules with.
Oh,
you could
go on.
You could
undo timelines. You could create new doctors, but you can't visit I don't understand that.
I just thought about something. And this is going to sound stupid, I know. But what happens if he says that since the 8th Doctor...
Nothing stupider than a cement block woman.
No. I'm not being... All right, just think about it. What happens now, and I'm just going back to the split in the series. What happens if after the 8th they say, you're in a parallel universe.
I would freaking hate that crap.
And I'm not being rude, and the Metacrisis Doctor was actually in the real Earth.
I don't know. I'll tell you right now, I actually suspected that in the 11th Doctor that he was in a parallel thing for a little while.
Because I'm like you're saying, there's classic companions and you're not bumping into them. Where are they then if they're not in the real Earth? It must be a parallel one.
I'm telling you, bumped into two companions was with Family Reunion and a Sarah Jane Adventure. And even then, that was...
Well, if he was in a parallel universe, you could explain it away that once David Tennant regenerated, he basically screwed up the TARDIS so much that it, while it was exploding, went to a parallel world. And you could say the whole time that the 11th was in there.
And the crack in the wall was actually the real world.
the 12th is in a parallel, right?
Yeah.
Well, no, that wouldn't make any sense, because then the 10th, no, you can't do a parallel world. It wouldn't make sense to do a parallel.
Well, we don't know with Moffat, do we?
That's the thing that scares me, is that certain rules that were for Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure became Doctor Who rules when Moffat took over.
Yeah.
And that's supposed to be a spin. That was supposed to be a parody, spoof, that Bill and Ted wrote letters to each other, and then that's what the Doctor did with the 11th.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, oh.
It's like that phone call where, where Matt Smith phoned Clara at the precise time that he had just finished regenerating.
Well, I like that. It was before he regenerated, but I
know. I like that as well. Because
I knew he did that when the phone was out.
Yeah. Yeah, I like that.
I called that before anybody called that. I said he's going to... I said it on the show that he was going to be in the next episode and be like, no way. And I'm like, Matt Smith's going to be in
the new series
and he's going to call Clara, and nobody's like, they thought I was crazy. And guess what? I called that too.
Yeah, and it's going to be his final goodbye. And I'm not being rude. It's always saying stuff like that, but then you don't know what he's going to do next, Moffat, then do you? It's like he's gonna change this, like say splitting in half, and then in the next series he's gonna probably split it again.
You could make his sonic screwdriver a TARDIS, because I don't know what he's gonna do. You could make a Doctor No a TARDIS anymore.
Hologram TARDIS.
I don't know what he could do. That's the thing I'm worried about with certain things. But I don't want the fan base to be split. It's already, split 15,000 times. But we'll see.
Well, it's going to be one of them. It's going to be one of them.
We didn't get to an everything show, by the way. I got to tell you. We spent, like, hours on this podcast. We didn't even get to a damn everything show.
Well,
I didn't get to talk about Glenn and the Green Balloons, Gloria. I didn't even... Willie Woodpecker. I'm that old. Thank you.
Well, let's be honest. I think we've had more fun with Doctor Who at the moment than.
Well, that's what everybody. That's the favorite show everybody loves in this channel.
That's what I mean.
So do I, actually.
Yeah, I could spend hours talking about it and not be worried.
Yeah.
I'm just curious as well, because in the classic Who, I'm not being rude, he had all them question marks. Like T-shirts and like Peter Capaldi said to us.
We're fans of Doctor Who. I mean, I just don't see it.
I know. Yeah, isn't it though? He's like, he joked with Osgood about underpants, like under like question mark underpants. We never saw him.
The amount of money I spent on those Titan toys, I probably could have bought a car. Honestly.
Yeah. I know. I wouldn't be surprised.
I got in trouble a couple of times then.
Please don't tell me you're going to get any more.
I want to do my new book, okay? I've been doing stuff for everybody. Yes, I bought the Titans figures for me, yes, but I bought another PlayStation 4. I've done whatever. I think it's time now. I really want my 12th book. I really want to do that. So hopefully I could actually put money away for that and do that. Because it's basically done anyway, so.
All you've got to do is just save the money.
It's not that easy.
Yeah, exactly. We say that about
money. When a new sonic screwdriver is coming out!
Yeah, that's what...
Another 2 years.
Yeah, that's what everyone's forgetting, though. In this day and age, it's like, oh, we're going to save some money. Oh, no, we've got to pay bills now, and we've got to buy this for ourselves.
Let me tell you something. I don't know how I had more money when I was younger, but when I was younger and I worked in retail, I bought cases. I was so crazy. I bought cases and cases of Star Trek. I didn't even know it was in the damn case, because I had to have cases of Deep Space Nine, cases of Next Generation, cases of Marvel Superheroes, cases of Star Wars when it came back in 1995, and they did the special editions and stuff, and different molds for the figures. I used to buy friggin' everything, okay? I used to go to WrestleMania and spend hundreds of dollars. I used to go to Monday Night Raw and spend tons of money. I used to go to Kiss concerts and going to Florida for a month. So when I lived the life when I was young, and I bought everything I bought myself.
Yeah.
Everything.
Then in, now, that's the thing, it's you look like, back on it and...
No, I had a great time.
That's what I mean. You look back on it and think, I had a great time. And now when like you want to save money...
I made more money back then.
Yeah. Now you look think to yourself, it's not, I wish I had money now.
No, it's called, you know, I have kids and I have responsibilities and I have more expenses. And I do make a lot more money than I used to, but
it's still gold.
There's more responsibilities, basically. You know,
Scott gets me. It still goes down the drain on certain stuff.
Listen, I'm pretty happy in my life right now. I'm, you know, gonna get married next year, so I'm happy.
So is it?
No, it's not. It's not. I think pop.
Well,
what?
Right.
Well,
so
did I miss
the
news here?
No. This is I'm gonna real Whovian's kiss. Let's talk about the doctor.
It's gonna be a Doctor Who wedding.
That's what I was saying.
No, she's not.
You're gonna be River Song. You're gonna be.
Hey. And then they're gonna be in the. And then they're gonna sing Grease Lightning in the car. Or Forever Young.
Or better yet, get John Barrowman, because he's supposed to do concerts every now and then.
Oh my god. Go drive and walk, talk like you were not. No. Yeah, 2016 I'm going to get married, but that's next year. That's like...
That's a world exclusive.
Let's not. I'm not the focus. This is removing. Thank you. I should have. I spit that out like a doctor spits out. Gloria, what a congratulations, Gloria.
I'll just say one thing. Congratulations.
I didn't even ask her yet. I know she was going to say yes, but thank you, Gloria, for the fact.
I've never seen this episode, man.
Stop it! Okay. I don't want to be the focus of this episode.
Okay,
I just said, I threw the line out there and everybody reacted.
Oh,
we should have really talked about that off air.
I'm not wearing TARDIS blue suit either. Okay?
No. You know, you'll wear a brown suit, won't you? You'll wear a David Tennant brown suit.
You'll have a celery on his lapel.
Or you'll go in a Dalek. You'll go in a Dalek like the Baldy.
That's what the honeymoon's going to be in the UK? Is that what you're saying? I'm going to go to the UK for my honeymoon?
You're going to go to Wales, ain't you, and see the Doctor Who get filmed.
On my honeymoon?
Yes.
Hang on, Mrs. I just got to go to see Doctor Who. It's getting filmed. Oh, hang on, I'm going to be in it. I'm going to be late.
All right. Anyway, back to our regularly scheduled broadcast.
Yeah, after a 15-minute delay.
So.
Right.
What was it?
I don't know now. Where were we?
We were on about
thank
wedding.
Thank you for the text, Gloria. I appreciate it. All right, so anyway, I want Doctor Who to not...
To get married.
No. All right, people, let's calm down.
Listen, I said it. Gloria, I said it. The doctor was in a car. We were trying to explain the Wedding River Song. And the way I explained it was the doctor was in a car, the doors were closed, and River was next to their car, and they got married. He was in the car, but they got married, meaning that he was in the Tesla Lecter car. Okay? And it's technically still a marriage, even though... She kissed a bumper or whatever.
Because the only way it would make it not official is if he didn't want to, and he was if he was like mind controlled. He wasn't. He was in there.
Even though she kissed, even though basically she kissed a car door bumper, he still.
He okayed it. He walked through.
I kissed a boy and I liked it.
Oh my gosh.
But we're
just getting silly now.
She was talking through the test collector, so since he was able to talk through the test collector, he was all for it. So.
At least you can't say I'm dull.
I gotta say, I broke my own rule where I send no curse into the cast. I must have cursed tons of times. My fault. I apologize. I should be held accountable, too. Damn.
We should all be accountable, but who gives a damn?
I'm gonna get into this one.
Now it just gets silly.
All right, so anyway.
It got silly from the wedding.
Listen. he didn't marry Marilyn Monroe. Anyway. He didn't marry Marilyn Monroe, and I don't count the World II wedding either.
He says it wasn't official at the end. He said it wasn't legit, the place, the chapel, so.
Yeah.
I'm still trying
you know
to think
what
of...
I would, you know what I would do? If I was writing for River Song, and she wanted to be the Doctor's one and only, I would have her regenerate into another incarnation, go back in time, and she actually turned out to be his first wife.
Well, yeah, Marilyn Monroe.
It's possible. I mean, couldn't she time travel back to it now that
right, like she could technically be his first wife because she regenerated, and that's really her role.
So, put it this way. So, do you think that David Tennant went to see Peter Capaldi's wedding to River?
Yes.
Yes.
Well, then, yes. If that's the case, then we should see him there in some kind of form.
Maybe not. It could happen off screen because off.
Let me ask you a question.
It could be mentioned.
Why was David Tennant and Russell T. Davis at filming a Doctor Who? Was it for the finale? Was it for the Christmas special?
That's the only way I'm thinking of it.
Maybe they were doing both, and they just didn't want to tell the fans. Like,
was it the Christmas special? Maybe.
Maybe.
David Tennant's in the Christmas special.
And that's why it's called the Husbands of Riversong. Hello.
Yeah, and I never got that. I can't. I'm talking to sound. I did not get that. I'm like,
Like I said already, why is it that us girls got it, but the guys don't?
I don't know. Wait, hold on, Ray. Hold on. Why should I get it?
Well, you're going to be in that kind of predicament like next year.
Wait. What am I saying? Why should I get it? Why should I get it?
Raymond, you are hilarious. He said because you're going to be in that same predicament next year. Raymond, I love you. That's so funny.
Damn.
I told you, at least I'm not dull.
I'm going to say this. Being the pessimist of the group, do not
yes,
be
Sally
surprised.
Noble.
Don't be surprised if you do
You're
not
noble
see
too,
David Tennant.
Sally. Why?
Don't be surprised if you don't see David Tennant.
Well, hang on.
Because it might be just like a fluke, and we might not see him at all.
But why can husbands mean husbands as different people other than the doctor?
It could, but it seems more likely because it's almost as if it's like trying to trick you.
Wasn't the guy from the church technically her husband?
Huh?
Wasn't the Time Angels that guy her husband?
No. She didn't fancy him.
What happens if I'm... Well, think about it. If David Tennant... if David Tennant was in the episode, like Christmas special, what happens if he was on that spaceship which crashed?
They get married.
That would be so shocking. Because then it'd be like, then Eleven as, you know, when he sees her as Eleven for the first time, you know, in the Time of Angels, that'd be so funny. Because then he's like, River? And she like gets up and, I don't know.
Well, you know what would be funny? If at the end of the episode she finds out he's a doctor, and just like a perfect gentleman, he's like, I want to do this proper, and he's got a real justice of the peace, and he's like, and I'm inviting my best man, and he has a 10th doctor there with mouth and jaws.
Oh yeah, and the 8th doctor as well. Like, yeah, these are my two best men.
But see, Donna should be there too because she's met River.
Yeah, she did.
Right.
Yeah.
River didn't meet Donna.
No, because if you remember, Donna said to her, "Well, where's me? Where am I?"
River did not meet Donna. She
heard
just about
knew that. Of her. Yeah, right. The dark. She must like know because
so
the
she
doctor
didn't
told
meet,
her.
She didn't know her again. No. Yeah. But she did see the 10th before.
Yeah.
She was not surprised in the least.
That line in Titans in the Library or something. Like, you're so young. And he's like,
that, like I said, that's the first time she, like, maybe she had David, like, she was in an episode.
With
David
Tennant,
and she didn't look in his eyes. She just didn't look in his eyes.
Older, or an older kid, like the
same. Yeah, it is, right.
The only time she got a closer look is because why don't you remember any of these adventures? She's like, how young are you? Right.
Yeah. She's looking at him like she's shocked that he can't remember or doesn't. He's not saying, yes, we did that one. Yes, we did this one. And he's like basically staring at her like, who are you? And then she notices how he's acting, and she finally looks at his eyes and realizes, you look really young.
Right.
So do you think, I know it was written for the 10th, but do you think that it was supposed to be a message for the 11th?
No.
Or the 12.
No, when David Tennant said that in Blink, there was no 11, so it's like, we don't know what doctors he was talking about. We don't even know River, because she wasn't even existing by then.
No, I was talking about signing it in the library when we got the message.
Oh, the message,
was that meant for 11 or the 12?
It could have been for 11 or 12, you never
probably
know.
Was for 12.
She was actually doing it for, yeah, it was
probably for 12. 12. And he was in that time, so.
Mm-hmm.
Probably.
Oh, God.
You know, Joe, remember how I acted with
just,
that first
I just feel my
them?
Drink.
Remember how I acted whenever that one picture of them where they're inside the TARDIS and they're both working on with the controls, and I freaked out? Well, you can only imagine how freaked out I was when we got that official picture.
I know. And there's been many pictures.
Yes. But I mean, with the one that you were showing, that was the first one I saw.
Oh, the TARDIS?
Yeah. No, yeah. The one that we were showing on this episode, the one where it shows the new suit, the crazy suit. That one. That was the first one I saw of the official pictures. And freaked out. I was like freaking out. I was like screaming.
Freak
right,
out!
Last question of the day. last question of the cast, and I'm going to have to end the cast.
Okay.
Dream casting, what actor from other shows do you want to appear in Doctor Who? And I'm going to go first. I want Andrew Lincoln, Rick from Walking Dead, in an episode of Doctor Who. All right. What do you want, Gloria?
It's just one. That's kind of hard. But I like the idea of Adrian Lequin, but I really like Lauren Cohen, Maggie from The Walking Dead. She would be cool.
And Doctor?
She's already British, so she has the. They're both actually, so that would be appropriate. Okay.
Second choice would be Lady Gaga, but whatever. I know. Ray?
I'm going to be crazy here. I'm going to say one of the Americans, I'm going to say David Duchovny or, what's
David
the name?
Duchovny?
Yeah, from the X-Files.
Okay.
Or, what's the name? Scully.
Julian Ames. Yeah.
Yeah, one of them two.
Who was rumored to play the Ronnie for a long time.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, Sally,
Kate Winslet, because she was actually going to be, she was like one of the first choices for River Song.
Oh.
But then, of course, Alex got the part instead of Kate Winslet, so.
Well, she played a younger version.
Yeah.
Might as well bring Russell Crowe in.
That's a little bit of, like, facts, little tit, like, trivia. Yeah.
All
right. Sally. Oh, it's Ray. No,
Scott.
We said you were Ray.
Scott.
Yeah.
It's Scott in it.
No, Sally's got to go.
Okay. Years ago on ER, the actor Noah Wiley, he played librarians. I don't know if anybody's watched that show.
Yeah.
I think he'd be really good.
Yeah.
What about Dream Doctor?
Oh, no, we're going one question because I have to end the cast.
All right, so
you said that. What about you, Scott?
I'm going to have to say it's a toss-up between either Sally Field or Angela Cartwright.
Wow.
Oh, that's surprising.
Sally Field, that's actually...
Interesting. All right, guys. That's been a very long episode, but thank you very much. Had a lot of fun.
Yeah, I'm glad my eyes did managed to stay open.
Time flies when we're having fun.
Welcome back, Reenie.
Right. Well, it's been a great episode.
And on that note, guys, thanks a lot. Take care. Bye for now.
Ciao.